In this video, we'll be discussing about the flexor retinaculum of the hand. We will discuss about the attachment of the flexor retinaculum. We will be discussing the relations and we will draw the diagram. So first of all, about the attachment of the flexor retinaculum. So attachment is discussed first. So for this, we will be marking some important bony landmarks here. We will be drawing carpal bones here, that is, this is the lateral aspect, this is the medial aspect. On the lateral aspect, you have bone here, which is known as the tubercle of the scaphoid. Tubercle of the scaphoid. And distal to this, you have trapezium, that is the crest of trapezium. Crest of trapezium. And on the medial aspect, we have the pisiform bone and distal to this we have the hook of Hammett. These are the important bony landmarks. These are the carpal bones, hook of Hammett. So now the flexor retinaculum is a thick fibrous band which extends across these carpal bones. It is attached laterally to the tubercle of the scaphoid and the crest of trapezium, and it is attached medially to the pisiform and the hook of Hammett. So the flexor retinaculum is like this. So the attachment is laterally, the flexor retinaculum is attached to the tubercle of scaphoid and the crest of trapezium. Medially, it is attached to the pisiform bone and hook of Hammett. Actually, what is this flexor retinaculum? It is a thick fibrous band which is formed by the condensation of the prefacia. Thick fibrous band formed by the condensation of defacia in the carpal region. Condensation of defacia. In the carpal region. So actually see that these are the carpal bones. So there is an anterior concavity of the carpal bones you can see here. Actually the flexor retinaculum extends like this, it bridges the anterior concavity of the carpal bones. So by bridging the anterior concavity of the carpal bones, it forms a tunnel here. You can see that between the flexor retinaculum and the anterior concavity formed by the carpal bone, there is a tunnel here. This tunnel is known as carpal tunnel. So carpal tunnel is formed between the flexor retinaculum and the anterior concavity of the carpal bones. So the flexor retinaculum is extending or bridging the anterior concavity of the carpal bones. Now we look at the relations of the flexor retinaculum. So what are the relations? Now we'll be drawing the diagram here. We'll be drawing the distal carpal bones here. On the lateral aspect, this is the lateral aspect and this is the medial aspect. You have on the lateral aspect, that is the distal bone, is the trapezium, and here you have the Hammett, trapezium. This is the Hammett. And the flexor retinaculum extends like this between the trapezium and the Hammett. It extends like this. This is the flexor retinaculum. So it is bridging the concavity of the carpal bones like this. Now we will look into the extensions of the flexor retinaculum, that are the slips of the flexor retinaculum. Slips means some lateral and medial extensions are there. So you can see on the medial aspect, it gives a medial superficial slip like this. So here you have the hypothenar muscles. This is the hypothenar muscle. Here you are having the thenar muscle from the flexor retinaculum. So this is the hypothenar muscle on the medial side, and the lateral side you have the thenar muscle. Now the flexor retinaculum, it gives a medial slip here, and the medial slip is attached, medial superficial slip is attached to the pisiform bone. So this medial slip of the flexor retinaculum, so this is the flexor retinaculum, this is the medial slip, and the medial slip is also known as the volar carpal ligament. Carpal ligament. So which are the slips? First one is the medial superficial slip. Medial superficial also known as the volar carpal ligament. It is attached to the pisiform bone. That is the first one. And the second one, it has a lateral slip. Lateral slip is a deeper one. That is, the flexor retinaculum on the lateral side sends a deep slip which is attached to the medial lip of the groove of trapezium. So this is the deep slip, lateral deep slip of the flexor retinaculum. So second one is a lateral deep slip, and it is attached to medial lip of groove on trapezium. So now let us look at the relations of the flexor retinaculum. First we will look at the superficial relations, that is superficial, the structures which are passing superficial to the flexor retinaculum. Now look at the diagram. You can see that there is a tendon which is passing superficial to the flexor retinaculum. That is the tendon of palmaris longus. So this is the tendon of palmaris longus. So first one is tendon of palmaris longus. The second one is, there are two nerves here. On the lateral side you have the palmar cutaneous branch of median nerve. On the medial side you have the palmar cutaneous branch of ulnar nerve. So we will mark it as two here. Two is palmar cutaneous branch of median nerve. Palmar cutaneous branch of median nerve. On the medial side, this is number 3. Number 3 is palmar cutaneous branch of ulnar nerve. Now, other superficial structures are, so So you have seen that there is a volar carpal ligament. So between the volar carpal ligament and the flexor retinaculum, that is, it is superficial to the flexor retinaculum, we have ulnar vessels and the ulnar nerve. So other superficial structures are ulnar vessels and ulnar nerve. And this is located between the volar carpal ligament and flexor retinaculum. So these are the structures which are passing superficial to the flexor retinaculum. Now we will look at the deep structures. Which structures passing deep to the flexor retinaculum. So on the lateral side there is a tendon, that is there is a deep tendon which is present here, and the bursae around this. So this one is marked as, this one is the, so we are discussing which one, deep relations, deep to flexor retinaculum, structures passing deep to flexor retinaculum. So on the lateral side, on the deeper aspect, we have the tendon of, this is the flexor pollicis longus tendon. Tendon of flexor pollicis longus plus what, the radial bursae around that tendon, that is radial bursae, and we have superficial four tendons, that is the tendon of flexor digitorum superficialis, and deep to that there is tendon of flexor digitorum profundus. So this is flexor digitorum superficialis, and posterior to that flexor digitorum profundus, and the bursae which is present around this is the ulnar bursae. So we have four tendons of flexor digitorum superficialis, four tendons of flexor digitorum profundus, and fifth one, there is a nerve which is present deep to the flexor retinaculum, that nerve gets entrapped in carpal tunnel syndrome. So that nerve is the median nerve. This is present in the lateral aspect. This is the median nerve present deep to the flexor retinaculum. Median nerve. So that the structure is the median nerve. So the ulnar bursae is also present. Ulnar bursa. The other structure is, so between the flexor retinaculum and the deep slip, you have a tendon, that is the tendon of flexor carpe radialis. This is tendon of flexor carpe radialis, which is present between the flexor retinaculum and the deep slip. That is, seventh one is tendon of flexor carpe radialis. So these are the structures which are present superficial and deep to the flexor retinaculum. So that is all about the flexor retinaculum. Thank you for watching this video. To see more videos from our channel, please subscribe to our channel. Thank you.